Okay, so it's not often that I report on leaks. In fact, I never do it. And the reason why is just because things are always up in air and subjects can change. I don't want to ever put out false information. But leaks DBD, our boy leaks DBD, has some interesting information about the next chapter release. The 5.2 update and the 5.3 update are split. So the 5.2 update, the next chapter, is only going to have a killer. Right now, it is supposedly a licensed killer. Go ahead, speculate, whatever. Maybe a new map, maybe not. But you're going to get the killer, some perks, and then a month and a half later, with the mid-chapter, in the 5.3 release, you're going to get a new survivor with their perks and maybe a map. I don't know. The point here is, I think that this release schedule, even though they're only doing it for like contractual obligations and whatever, they can't put licensed content with original content, makes perfect sense. I think Behavior moving forward should always release content like this. Every single time. And the reason why is because it's less downtime between chapter releases. When you release a chapter, Behavior, when you release a chapter, it is 3 months of wait time for the next chapter. That's 3 months where there's not a whole lot going on. Yes, there's the mid chapter, but the mid chapters tend to just kind of be touching up things in the game, right? Oh, we've updated this map. Hey, we fixed this bug. Hey, there's a few perk changes here. I looking back at the mid chapters, there's been 3 total mid chapters that I've been excited for, and they're all 0.7 releases. I don't know what this shit is. I think it's just like some, they gotta be trolling us or something. But the 2.7 update, the 3.7 update, and the 4.7 update all have been like the best mid chapters. 2.7, endgame collapse, legion update, pig update, deep wound update, bunch of updates, perk updates. It was good. 3.7, I think there were just a handful of perk updates, killer updates, and then it was just maps. Like, they changed like 20 maps. They fixed up some tiles, shrunk the size, all that kind of stuff. 4.7, they just went up and just changed like 3 fucking killers at once. They like, oh, Freddy? Yeah, we're nerfing Freddy. Oh, Demo? We're buffing Demo. Oh, Huntress? We're fixing her add-ons. In one update. Jesus fucking Christ. Every 0.7 update. I can't make this shit up. Every 0.7 update. OP, dude. Nerf 0.7. Actually, don't. Please don't. Please don't. It's actually so good. Please, never change the 0.7 updates. But yeah, all 3 that I have experienced in my time playing this game have been like the best mid-chapters. But mid-chapters don't really add new content. They sort of just fix up the game a bit. And as a content creator, you know, you get the big chapter release, you make the content on that. It's super entertaining for like 2 weeks. It's like, oh yeah, whatever. New killer, cool. New power, cool. Perks, whatever. Survivor, meh. Depends on the survivor, but yeah, meh. Possibly a new map, okay. Cool. And then sort of gets stale. Like, there's not a whole lot to really work with, and you're just sort of going back to the same old thing that you used to do until the next chapter. The mid chapter comes out. That's exciting. You can, you know, you talk about that a little bit. You share what's going on. Yeah, there's improvements to the game. Maybe a perk gets changed. You make like a gimmick build or something about it. I don't know. You fucking, people make some content out of literally a cardboard box. I don't know how people do it with the mid-chapters. But yeah, you have that going on. And then you gotta wait some more time. And then the chapter releases. Oh, okay, chapter's out. Okay, finally new content. Releasing the killer and the survivor separately would eliminate that downtime completely. Now, this is just from the content creator perspective, right? A new killer comes out with their perks and a power, possibly a map. It's exciting. You make, you know, content on that for 2 weeks. Maybe if you're a player, you are enjoying that for a good 2-3 weeks. And then you sort of, you know, wait a bit. Oh, mid-chapter's out. New survivor. Okay, new survivor's out. Some perks came out. Cool, let's play with that for a little bit. And then you're waiting again, you know, 2-3 weeks, and then, oh, here we go, another chapter, another killer. Okay, awesome. Like, that would keep the content cycle flowing. There's always something to look forward to with Dead by Daylight, always something to come back to. And in addition to that, you'd have like the Rift and stuff. You'd have the Rift, you'd have a new survivor, some perks there. And in the next update, you know they're going to be updating the previous killer in addition to releasing a new killer. And when they update, or when they release a new survivor, you know they're going to be updating the previous survivor and updating their perks. That's awesome, man. That is so fucking cool. I just think this release schedule would just be a million times better. It's drip feeding content. It keeps the flow of content going. It's like GTA Online. I think GTA Online has mastered the art of drip feeding like gameplay content, because they'll have two big releases throughout the year, right? Maybe a heist or something, and then a new business, right? And throughout those two updates, in between downtime, they'll have like contact missions being released, new adversary modes. Double money and RP whole weeks, like for 2 weeks if you play a certain thing, you get some money, you know, whatever. They have bonuses and like promotions and stuff, so like, oh, if you buy this business, you'll get like a little bit extra on top. Like, oh, you buy this, you also get this car or something. And that's another thing, they release new cars, new outfits. Just, they keep the content cycle flowing. Same with Black Ops Cold War. Not as well, but they still do it pretty fucking well. And they'll have, like, the big season update with the Battle Pass. Then a little bit later, they'll have the new maps released for multiplayer. Some new zombie stuff. Maybe a perk here and there. Just new stuff. And in between those, they have new skins and cosmetics and stuff. And it just keeps the train of content flowing. And so, behavior, I think it would be a really good idea if you were to release a killer and survivor separately. A killer in like where you would normally do a chapter release, and a survivor in the mid-chapter release. I think that cycle would be infinitely better and would keep players entertained with the game for a lot longer. Because there's always something new. And it's easier to wait like 3-4 weeks to get the new content, because you have the PTB, and then after that PTB, you get the actual release on the live game. So that's why I'm saying it's like 3-4 weeks rather than the full 6 weeks, because it is 6 weeks. It is a month and a half in between releases, but it's about 3 or 4 weeks between PTB and live. So that's why I'm saying 3 to 4 weeks, because that's when the hype for the new content starts releasing. Anyway, that's a bit of a side point. Anyway, I just think it would bridge the gap between the downtime and the new releases. And yeah, let me know if you guys agree, if you think that this would actually just be a better release schedule, or if you're happy with the four main chapter releases, the four big content drops.